A very good morning, my dear students. So here is the lecture number 11 of chapter equilibrium unit 7, and hope you all got the things whatever I have explained in the last video. That was numerical complete and continuation. The numerical part will continue till the last of this topic of this chapter. Okay, so don't be panic and start practicing. As much as you will practice, you will be expert in this. Okay, so as usual, let's start the video with a quote, and the quote is: imagine with all your mind, believe with all your heart, achieve with all your might. So I hope this thing is very much clear to you. Like, whatever you think at the last, we can say now, beyond your thinking you can think. So just imagine whatever you can think and believe in your imagination with all your heart. Don't say that ye nahi possible hai. Everything is possible. If you will believe, you will get it. And then achieve with all your might. Jitni potential hai tumhare paas, jitna effort kar sakte ho, all put the all effort in that and achieve that. Okay, so okay, now continuation, and let's start this. And there was a numerical, there was a homework in last video, so that is calculate the pH value of 0.001 MHNO3, and next is that. So I hope you all got it, so just match the answer where I'm doing here. So for the first part, this since it is a strong acid, so H plus concentration will be equal to the HNO3 concentration, isn't it? And that will be 10 to the power minus 3. Can I write? Yes. So pH will be very simple. That is minus log H plus, and this is minus log 10 to the power minus 3. So just do this log 10 power m power n, n log m ho jayega. And this will be minus minus 3 log 10. Log 10 is equal to 1. So this is going to be plus 3. That means pH value is 3. Yes. Now for second part. Second part is strong base, so whatever the concentration of NaOH, that will be the same concentration for OH minus also, and that is 10 to the power minus 2. Yes, so in this case the OH concentration is given, so you cannot find pH directly. So first you find POH, and that is minus log H OH minus. Yes, sorry, and so this will be minus log 10 to the power minus 2, and hence it will be 2. So POH is 2. So what will be this? pH will be 14 minus 2, that means 12. Clear? Other way also you can do. Here you got the OH minus concentration. So we know that H plus concentration and OH minus concentration, that is equal to 10 to the power minus 14. So in that way you can find it. Yes? OH minus concentration, H plus concentration you have to find. So that you will get it 10 to the power minus 12, and then pH find karo, in the same way you will get that 12. So it is clear. Now move to next topic, and the next topic is type F, calculation of pH of very dilute acid or base solution for the solution on dilution. Like, if we dilute the solution, so what will happen, that H plus concentration increases, but it increases with the very small amount. So that is considered as very dilute acid or base. So how we will find the pH for this type of solution? So let's see with a question. First note, and note is, it may be noted that in aqueous solution of strong acid, the main source of H plus or H3O plus ion is the acid itself, unless the solution are very dilute. Like, see, in the aqueous solution, jab tak hum, we don't talk about the dilute one, तब तक वी विल से दैट द एच प्लस कंसेंट्रेशन जो है वो सिर्फ उस एसिड से ही आ रहा है. बट इफ इट इज वेरी डाइल्यूट, अगर हम वहां पर लिख देते हैं, देन एच प्लस कंसेंट्रेशन विल कम फ्रॉम वाटर ऑल्सो. दैट विल कम फ्रॉम वाटर ऑल्सो. सो इन दैट केस द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ एच प्लस विल नॉट बी एग्जैक्टली इक्वल टू द कंसेंट्रेशन ऑफ द एसिड. गॉट इट? सो लेट सी हाउ इट इज. If the molarity of the solution is equal to or less than 10 to the power minus 6 m, then the H plus and OH minus concentration obtained by ionization of water has also to be considered. Is it clear? That is, अगर less than है 10 to the power minus 6 से, अगर कम है, तो वहाँ पे हमें like what we say, we have to consider the H plus and OH minus concentration from the ionization of water also. That means we have to consider the H plus concentration and OH minus concentration of water also. So let's we will get it. We'll have a clear idea about this with the question. So let's start with the question. The question is that calculate the pH of 1 × 10⁻⁸ m solution of HCl. So it maximum strength, what they will do? They will say that 10⁻⁸. So we'll apply this pH formula and this they will say that 8. Just think of it. This is HCl and HCl is an acid. Yes. So can it have the pH more than 7? Yes, of course. 7 to neutral hi hota hai. Yes. So even 7 bhi nahi ho sakta iske liye, kyunki ye acid hai. तो 7 भी नहीं हो सकता तो हाउ कम दिस 8 विल बी गॉट इट सो दैट विल बी कंसीडर्ड एज रॉन्ग सो व्हाट इज द करेक्ट आइडिया टू करेक्ट वे टू डू सो हियर सिंस HCl इज देयर सो दैट इज गोइंग टू गिव यू H प्लस एंड Cl माइनस सो हियर H प्लस कंसेंट्रेशन वी गॉट इट 10 टू द पावर माइनस 8 इन दिस केस वी विल कंसीडर दैट एज आई सेड दैट कि 10 टू द पावर माइनस 6 से अगर लेस होगा तो दिस इज लेस वैल्यू सो इफ इट इज लेस देन 10 टू द पावर माइनस 6 सो व्हाट वी हैव टू डू वी हैव टू कंसीडर द H plus concentration from water also. So water will dissociate in this form H plus and OH minus. And water, we know that the concentration, since it is neutral, so the concentration will be 10 to the minus 7. So its concentration is 10 to the power minus 7. This part you have to assume. Got it? So now the total H plus is what? Total H plus concentration is 10 to the power minus 8 plus 10 to the power minus 7. Isn't it? So just find this, add it. Will it be simply added? The power will be added? No, this is plus sign. It's not multiplication sign. So what we'll do, it will be 10 to the minus 1 into 10 to the minus 7. Can I write like this? Plus 10 to the minus 7. So here you just take it common and this will be 0.1 plus 1 into 10 to the minus 7. So that means it is going to be 1.1 into 10 to the minus 7. Clear? Now find the pH. So pH is equal to formula minus log H plus. Yes, and this minus log H plus concentration is not 10 to the power minus 8, it is 1.1 into 10 to the power minus 7. So if you will calculate it, it is log 1.1 and here it will be minus 7 log 10, log 10 value 1. So this is minus log 1.1 ki value if you will put. Okay, so if you'll check this 1.1 in the log value, so it is coming 0.0414, sorry. Okay, minus 7. So this will be less than 7, slightly less than 7. So you can say that 6.96 almost. Yes, so that almost I'm writing, I have not calculated properly. So this type of question can be directly said if in the MCQ it is given just what we have to consider, like jo 10 to the power minus 7 se bahut close value hogi that we will put. Got it? 7 ke jo niche hogi kam honi chahiye, but it should be very close to that 7. So wo wali value pe aap tick kar doge, it will be correct. Got it? So, like if it is given 6.56, 6.85, 7.02 and 8. So in general, it's so simple. बच्चे जो हैं वो इसको टिक कर देंगे. So that is wrong. What should be the correct answer? This one is the correct answer. MCQ, you can do it in that way. Got it? Okay. Now move to next question. And the next question is pH of a solution of a strong acid is 5. pH is given 5. What will be the pH of the solution obtained by diluting the given solution 100 times? So that means if here the concentration, if you will find the concentration, H plus concentration, we will get it like 10 to the power minus 5, isn't it? By the same way, anti-log pH, you do it and you'll get it like, yes? Okay, so earlier the concentration is 10 to the power minus 5, okay? Now it is going to be diluted by 100 times. So concentration, that means number of mole is not going to change, but volume will be changed. So if we will talk about this, it is N by V. So earlier this one is same. Okay, now what is happening? NV into 100. Yes, so this one is same and ye kitna tha? 10 to the power minus 5. So what we will do? 10 to the minus 5 upon 10 to 100. Yani that means 10 to the power minus 7. So this is the H plus concentration now. Okay, so this is the H plus concentration of the strong acid now. Okay, but at this time, water concentration is also there. So water, like for water, can I write like this for water? This is the H plus and OH minus is equal to 10 to the power minus 14. This is, yes. I don't know what is the concentration of H plus and OH minus in the water. Okay, so what I will do, I will just assume that this is X. For the neutral I'm taking, so this is X and this is X. Both are same, equal number, equal moles, equal concentration. So I'm taking it as a X. This one is X, this one is also X. So now, if in water it is concentration of H plus is X. So total concentration kitna ho jayega H ka? This plus this, isn't it? So can I write like this, X plus 10 to the power minus 7. And X OH minus concentration, as I told you that it is equal, like X karte. So this is minus 14. So here is it will form a quadratic equation, and quadratic equation ko, when you will solve it, you will get that X is also coming 10 to the power minus 7. You solve it. Okay. So now total H plus concentration jo hoga, total H plus concentration, that is going to be 10 to the power minus 7 plus 10 to the power minus 7. ये कहां से आया? ये एसिड, सॉरी HCl ने. नो, वी शुड राइट एसिड. दिस इज एसिड, ओके, एंड दिस केम फ्रॉम वाटर. ओके, सो नाउ इट विल बी 10 टू द माइनस 7 कॉमन, सो इट विल बी 2 इंटू 10 टू द पावर माइनस 7, इजंट इट? इफ आई विल डू कैलकुलेशन, सो फाइंड द पीएच ओवर हियर, दिस इज गोइंग टू बी माइनस लॉग एच प्लस, एंड हियर minus log 2 into 10 to the power minus 7, so you will do that minus log, and this is 2 minus 7 log 10 key value 1, so 0.3010, this one is 0.3010 log 2, and this one is plus 7, so solve it, and it will be approximately 6 point something 9 ke aas paas aayega, 993. ओके, सो अराउंड 7, बट एग्जैक्टली 7 नहीं आएगा. आर यू गेटिंग इट? गॉट इट? सो दिस इज द वे टू सॉल्व दिस क्वेश्चन, दिस टाइप ऑफ क्वेश्चंस. लेट्स मूव टू नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, एंड द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज कैलकुलेट द पीएच ऑफ 1 इनटू 10 माइनस 8 एम एन एओएच सॉल्यूशन. सो हियर दिस इज, वी विल गेट दैट ओएच माइनस कंसंट्रेशन, व्हाट इट इज, 10 टू द पावर माइनस 8. सिमिलरली वी विल डू एज वी हैव डन इन द प्रीवियस क्वेश्चन, वी विल डू इट. Okay, so here assume H plus concentration and OH minus concentration. So suppose that from water we are getting, from water OH minus concentration we are getting 10 to the X. Okay, so total OH minus kitna ho jayega? That is 10 to the power minus 8 plus X, isn't it? So now this is the formula, H plus concentration, OH minus concentration, and that is equal to 10 to the minus 14. So here H plus concentration also X, because H and OH we will consider as the same. And OH minus concentration is 10 to the power minus 8 plus X is equal to 10 to the minus 14. So there is again the quadratic equation. So you just solve this X, and this time X will come. So here X key value jo hogi, that is coming 9.5 into 10 to the minus 8. Okay, you just calculate this by that using quadratic equation, and you'll get this 9.5 into 10 to the minus 8. So now total OH minus jo concentration hoga, wo hoga tumhara, this is 10 to the power minus 8 plus 9.5 into 10 to the minus 8. That means it is going to be 19.5 into 10 to the power, sorry, it is going to be 9.5 and 1 from here, so this is going to be 10.5 into 10 to the minus 18, and this OH minus concentration you got it, so you can find the POH, isn't it? POH is equal to minus log OH minus concentration, so minus log, and OH minus is 10 to the power 10.5 into 10 to the minus 8, so that will be minus log 10.5 minus 8 log 1. So let it be, and this is just find the 10.5 log value. So you will get, let me check. It is 0.212. Okay. So 0.212. sorry, 0.01. Now, before decimal, 2 digit over there. So what we will do? We'll subtract 1 from that, and it will be 1. Yes. So this will be 1.028212 minus 8. So just subtract it, and you will get that pH value around 7 point something. Yes. So just subtract it, and you will get it is coming 6.97. Okay. So this is the pOH. If you will find for pH for this, this is 14 minus 6.97. So it will be around 7.03, isn't it? So this is the pH for this solution. I hope it is clear. Yes. Now move to next thing, and that is relation between Ka and Kb. So like Ka is for acid and Kb is for base. So we will get the relation between Ka, Kb, and will be better if you will say the in bit and Kw. Okay, so Ka, Kw, and Ka, Kb, and Kw will get the relation between them. So for this, how to do that? Like we know that this is base. When the base base that gains H plus, and it will give you the conjugate acid, isn't it? Clear? Similarly, acid jo hoga, that will give you H plus, and after that conjugate base we will get. Yes. So for the equilibrium, if I am talking about equilibrium, so obviously it must be weak acid or weak base. Got it? So we will consider the weak acid and weak base. So yahan pe, assuming that acid is weak, and we are considering that acid is HA. A for acid, which gives H plus. Yes. So if we will make the reaction, we will write the reaction. HA will give what? H plus and A minus. Yes. But when it dissolves in water, so it will be better. It will be preferably written like this: HA plus H2O. And when it gives, it will give you H3O plus plus A minus. Clear? So for this weak acid, if I will write the Ka value for this, what I will write? H3O plus A minus upon HA, isn't it? Can I write? Is there any problem? So suppose this is the equation 1. Now similarly Kb ke liye, what we have to do for weak base. Okay, so this one is A minus jo hai wo hum yahan pe kya karte hain, isko hum weak base, ye acid hai. So this is A minus ko hum assume karte hain ki it is going to be conjugate base is weak base. Okay, so assuming conjugate base A minus is weak base, so what will happen? This A minus when A minus plus H2O, so this will give you wapas, we will get this HA plus OH minus, isn't it? Yes. So in this case, if I will write Kb, what I will write? HA OH minus upon A minus. This is equation 2. Now multiply Ka into Kb karo. So what you will get? If I am doing Ka into Kb, it is H3O plus A minus upon HA, and Kb ki value, this is HA OH minus upon A minus. Yes, so this is going to be cancelled out, HA, and this is going to give you H3O plus concentration into OH minus concentration, which is equal to Kw, isn't it? So we'll get a relation that is Ka into Kb is equal to Kw. And Kw ki value kitni hoti hai? 10 to the power minus 14. So we can write like this, that Ka into Kb is equal to Kw, and that is equal to 10 to the power minus 14. This is going to be a relation between Ka, Kb, and with respect to Kw. Yes. Now Next case we can do taking negative logarithm both side. Taking negative log both side. What will happen? Minus, and this is log minus log ka into kb is equal to minus log kw. Okay, so this is log m into n. So can I write like minus log ka minus log kb? Yes, is equal to minus log kw. And instead of this, I can write pka. Yes, minus, if I am taking it along with this minus ke saath agar main isko leti hu yahan pe, so here plus sign will be left out, isn't it? So plus, and this can be written as pkb is equal to, this is pkw, and pkw value will be 14. So this is the another relation between like pk, pkb, we can say. Got it? So the one relation, that is KAKB is equal to KW, and this is another PKPKB is equal to PKW. Now the next topic is polyprotic acid. As I have already explained about this protic, protic means this is going to give H plus. Yes? So poly means more than one H plus. Okay? So they are also called as polybasic acid. They are also called as polybasic acid. Okay? So polybasic acid, and the one which will give you more than one OH minus will be considered as polyacidic base. Clear? Okay, so now just let me write the definition. The acids which gives more than one H plus ion when dissolved in water. Yes, so like if I'm talking about HCl, this is monoprotic because it is given H plus only, so this is called monoprotic. Similarly, if I'm talking about H2SO4, it will give you H plus and HSO4 minus first, and then this HSO4 minus will give you one more H plus to give SO4 minus. So since it is giving two H plus ions, so that's why it is called diprotic. Okay, similarly H3PO4 ki baat karte hain, to H3PO4 will give one H plus, and this will be H2PO4 minus. Now H2PO4 minus will give one more H plus to give HPO4 minus, and this HPO4 will further give one more H plus to give PO4 minus 3. Got it? So these are giving, they are giving in three steps, H plus in three steps, and that's why it is called triprotic also. If in this case I will write Ka1, Ka2, Ka3. So for this equation, if I will write Ka1 will be what? H plus H2PO4 minus 4 upon H3PO4. Similarly, Ka2, you can find this is H plus into HPO4 minus upon H2PO4 minus. Similarly, if I will write Ka3, this will be H plus plus PO4 minus 3 upon HPO4 minus. And now the first equation, if I'm considering it as a one equation, that means in one step, H3PO4 is going to give H3H plus and PO4 minus 3. So in this case, if I'm writing Ka, so what Ka, that is going to be H plus power 3 PO4 minus 3 upon H3PO4. So can I say that Ka is equal to Ka1 into Ka2 into Ka3? Yes or no? This is an equation. So we can write this as a Ka, let me write it here. Ka is equal to Ka1 into Ka2 into Ka3. Similarly, Kb will be equal to Kb1 into Kb2 into Kb3. Got it? And this is the point to be learned, that Ka is always, Ka1 is always greater than Ka2 is always greater than Ka3. So there is a point to be learned here. The point is, like, as the H plus ion decreases, that the acidic strength decreases. So let me write here, the acidic strength of polyprotic acid decreases as H plus ion are lost. Got it? जितना वो H plus lose करते जाएंगे, उनकी acidic strength कम होती जाएगी. Clear? So this is the concept. Sorry. So this is the concept. Make a point, make a box for this. And the next topic Okay, class, that's it for today. Thank you. And next topic will be common ion effect. Okay, let me write it here. Common ion effect with some questions and hydrolysis of salt, which will be almost last of this topic chapter. Okay, so get ready for that, more and more questions in the next video. So till then, thank you, class. Enjoy your studies.